English speaking course.
I'd like you to meet a friend of mine.
Long time no see, Tracy. How's it going?
Hey, Jack. It's nice to see you again. I'm pretty good. How about you?
I'm doing great, and I'd like you to meet a friend of mine.
Tracy, please meet Tom. Tom, please meet Tracy. Hey, you were the guys who helped me at the cinema last week.
Yes, it's me. I'm glad to meet you again on this occasion.
Wait, what? Do you guys already know each other?
You could say so. Like, last week, I was standing right behind Tracy while waiting to buy a movie ticket.
Yeah, and suddenly, there was a guy who elbowed me to try to get into the line. I was speechless, but thanks to Tom and the staff there, that man finally left with an angry face. Whoo!
I see. What an unforgettable experience, right?
Couldn't agree more. I'm afraid I have to leave.
Last week, a bag snatcher suddenly approached me, grabbed my bag, and ran away.
Gosh, was there anyone there to help you?
No, there was no one. I was screaming hopelessly to ask for help.
Then what happened?
I ran as quickly as possible to chase after my bag. But the thief was too fast.
Oh my God, that's bad. Were you able to get your bag back?
No, but do you want to hear how my bag was returned?
Wait, it's 10:35 a.m. now. I'm afraid I have to leave, Lucy.
Oh, it's okay. I'm almost done telling my story.
Okay, I'm all ears.
The thief discovered there was nothing valuable in my bag.
What? Then he threw it away or something?
Yes, you got it.
We've met before.
Excuse me, sir. Are you Mr. John?
Yes, I am. And you are?
Ah, yes. My name is William. I think we've met at a previous conference, haven't we?
Oh, I remember you. Are you Mr. William from Company Star?
Yes, that's me.
I'm so sorry for my bad memory.
No, it's okay. It's a pleasure to see you again at this conference.
Me too. Come to think of it, do you know what today's topic is about?
Brand awareness, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, I'm really enthusiastic about this topic.
Same here. I'm quite curious how everyone will discuss this.
Good for you.
Guess what? I've got an A+ for my chemistry test. Hey, good for you. What about you? Did you get a good mark? I've got a B+, but I'm totally satisfied with it since chemistry is not my strength. Ah, I see. Keep it up, friend. Thank you. Oh, I saw your other scores, and it was almost perfect with A and A+. I'm impressed, man. You inspire me to study harder. Huh, actually, there's nothing to boast about. You're also very humble. Can you share with me your tips to always have good marks? Well, I just listen to the lecture carefully and revise the lesson every day.
Take the medicine.
How are you today, Alice? Your face looks pale.
Yeah, I'm feeling a bit off today.
What's wrong?
I couldn't focus on the lecture and my head hurts.
Do you have any other symptoms?
No, just a headache.
I think you've probably been studying too hard. Do you think I should take a day off this afternoon? Definitely should. And take some medicine, too.
I will.
Oh, and don't forget to always keep yourself hydrated.
Thank you, Lucy. I will email my professor right now. When shall we meet?
We should decide on a date to do our group work.
Jenny's right. When shall we meet?
I'm free on Thursday afternoon.
I'm only available after 6 p.m. on Thursday.
It's quite difficult for us, right?
How about Sunday morning?
Sorry, I have a part-time job on Sunday.
Hey, shall we meet after class today?
I'm afraid we don't have enough time.
Don't worry, I think we can delegate tasks to each person first.
That's a good idea. Let's do it today since we are all busy.
Don't be upset.
What's the matter, Jane? Your face is a bit...
Our neighbors really pissed me off today.
Ugh!
How come?
You didn't come home last night, so you don't know. Our neighbors played music out loud, so I found it super distracting. So this morning, I knocked on their door and complained about the noise.
And guess what they said?
Did they say they wouldn't turn the volume off even if you complained?
Yes, exactly! Oh my God, can you believe it?
Okay, don't be upset.
I don't want to live here anymore.
Calm down, and we will tell the security guard later. I got fired.
I got fired.
What? Today?
Yes, just 1 hour ago.
Do you know the reasons why?
Because I didn't meet the deadline, and it happened many times.
Gosh, how are you feeling right now?
I'm great. Honestly, I didn't enjoy my job at all. And my manager's kinda serious. I don't like working with him.
I see. So, what's your plan now?
I think I will take a break for a year to identify what I like to do.
I think that's a good idea. What did you expect?
How was your blind date, Noah?
It's not as I expected.
What did you expect?
Well, the girl that I met was beautiful, but she had tattoos on her arm.
So, you found it not as you expected because she has tattoos?
Yes. I don't like people with tattoos on their bodies.
Oh, come on. But she is a polite girl, right?
Yes, and she knew how to start an interesting conversation. I enjoyed talking to her, but...
Man, I think you should consider seeing her next time. It's not easy to find a pretty and wise woman like her. And forget about the tattoos, man. You cannot tell about someone only with a tattoo, right?
Yeah, I will think about it again.
Can I have the check?
How was the meal, Lisa?
It was perfect. Thank you for inviting me.
I'm glad you enjoyed the meal. And let me pay for...
No, please let me do it. Waiter, can I have the check?
Please wait for a moment, madam.
Let me pay for it, Lisa.
You treated me so well today, David. Let me do something for you.
This is your bill.
Here, keep the change.
Thank you, madam.
I'm looking for a skirt.
Excuse me.
Good evening, madam. How can I help you?
I'm looking for an A-line yellow skirt. Do you have any?
We have a wide range of A-line skirts, madam. Please follow me this way. Unfortunately, we don't have any yellow skirts left. However, I think orange will also be a good idea for you. Would you like to try this orange skirt on, madam?
I love the bright colors. Let me try it. Thank you for your suggestions.
You're welcome, madam. The changing room is this way.
It's up to you.
Honey, what do you think I should wear to tonight's party? The green dress or the red one?
It's up to you, Bay. I think both of them suit you really well.
I cannot choose one. Can you help me?
So, the red one might be better.
But the green dress is cute too.
If so, you can wear the green one.
But don't you think the red one will make me look sexier?
Oh, you are so complicated. You want me to choose the dress for you, but you are denying my option.
But it's really hard to decide.
I think you can wear whatever you want, honey.
I am very grateful to you.
Hey, Kim, do you have a moment?
Sure, what's up?
Nothing much, but I would like to say thank you for today.
Sorry, but what did I do?
I am very grateful that you helped me to explain my absence to the professor.
Oh, that's okay. That's the thing I should do.
Would you like to go to the canteen with me? I will pay for the food.
Fantastic! I'm also hungry now.
Ha, I know it. Let's go.
So sorry about that.
Hey, good morning.
Good morning. Are you getting any better?
Yes, and thank you for helping me with the homework.
Oh, and can you give me back the notebook that you borrowed yesterday?
Wait, let me check. Oh, gosh, I forgot it. I'm so sorry about that. Let me take notes for you today. Will that be okay?
But I need to revise some lessons with my notebook.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay. I can check the slides that I saved on my laptop.
I will bring the notebook back to you this afternoon.
Okay, you don't have to rush. Hope you can help us.
Excuse me, Linda. I want to ask about what time the party starts.
Oh, it's 6 p.m. this afternoon.
Ah, I see. Okay, do you want me to come earlier and help you prepare?
That would be great, Sally. Hope you can help us.
Yes, don't worry. I will come at around 4:30 p.m.
Thank you so much.
By the way, do I need to bring along anything?
No, you don't. We will prepare everything at my house.
Okay, got it.
It's a good deal.
Your jacket is cool, Ed. Where did you buy it?
Oh, I bought it at the shopping center.
I see. I heard that shopping there is kind of expensive, right?
Exactly. But I got a good deal on this jacket. It's only $50.
Wait, what? How could it be cheap like that? I thought your jacket cost about $100 or $150.
Well, I bargained with the seller over the price of this jacket. And somehow, she decided to sell it to me for only $50.
That's a really good deal, bruh. Next time, I will definitely go shopping with you.
out of pocket.
Hello, Jenny. Why are you looking so anxious? I thought you picked up lots of good bargains in the Black Friday sale.
Yes, I did. And I was super excited.
That's good. But why do you look a bit sad now?
Because I'm totally out of pocket after spending all of my money on Black Friday.
Gosh, what are you going to do now?
I think I will have to stop eating for a while to save money.
But it will be extremely harmful to your health.
I have no choice.
Next time you have to control your shopping addiction, even if there is a flash sale.
All right.
What's the next step?
Hey, do you know how to join the cooking club at our school? I really want to become a member, but don't know how.
Oh, it's very simple. First, you have to fill in the application form on their website.
Okay, I already finished it. What's the next step?
Then you have to check your email regularly. They will inform you about the interview date within a week.
What? There will be an interview?
Yes, but don't worry. They will only ask you some questions about your interests, your cooking experience, blah, blah, blah.
I see. All right, I will check my email from now on.
Good luck, my friend. That's a lot of money.
I'm going to enter university next week.
Are you excited?
Yes, but I'm also worried.
About what?
Nothing. It's just about the financial problems. I decided to find a part-time job and not borrow any money from my parents.
That's really hard to achieve when you are in your first year.
Can I ask how much money you spend for your life per month?
Well, apart from paying the tuition, I usually spend up to $2,000 a month. I have to pay the rent, utilities, the internet, and so many more things.
Gosh, that's a lot of money. I don't know whether I can handle it or not.
You can do part-time jobs and find scholarships at school.
I'll try my best.
Great time to make a big life change. Hey, Jack. I've heard that something bad has happened to you lately. Are you okay now?
Not really. I've been kinda under stress lately.
Why? Because you have a lot of work to do or something?
I don't know. I feel hopeless right now.
You know what? I believe this is a great time to make big life changes. Do you have anything crazy that you want to do right now?
Right now, I want to quit my current job.
Wow! What leads you to that decision?
I feel stressed because of this job. I don't have any motivation to move on. So, if I have to make a big life change immediately, it would be to quit my job and have a vacation.
Fantastic! I'm glad that you know what is the best for you. It's now or never. Have you found a new job yet?
Not yet. I still have a lot of time.
You've been unemployed for 2 months, Tom. You have to find a job now.
I will do it tomorrow.
Come on, stop delaying, man. You must do it today. It's now or never.
Hey, I found a really interesting cat video. Look.
Stop being distracted by cat videos. Instead of scrolling your social media all day long, you can start looking for a job on the internet.
All right, all right. I will do it after watching this video.
I'm so disappointed in you, Tom.
I got to do it now. Hey, Jane. I've heard that there's a new restaurant opening in town, and it has a lot of good reviews. Want to have lunch there with me? I don't think I can make it. I'm buried in work today. But you cannot sit at the desk and work all the time like this. You have to eat something as well. I will eat after finishing this task. I've got to do it now, or I will be scolded by the manager. All right. Sorry, Anna. Maybe next time I will join you. Good luck with your work. I literally don't have an option.
Hey, have you decided which field you want to study at college?
I don't know. It's really difficult for me to choose.
Why do you think so?
Well, I don't have a knack for anything. My overall grades are terrible. I cannot sing, dance, or play sports. I literally don't have an option to choose any field at university.
Come on, don't be so pessimistic. I can see you're really good at drawing. Do you want to study arts?
I really want to, but my parents said studying arts would be a waste of time.
Please try to convince them again. You can develop the right skills if you choose the right majors.
I didn't really think about it.
Last night was fantastic. The food, the music, everything at the party was amazing, right? Not really. What? How can you say something like that? I thought you were really enjoying the party. Nah, I was just sitting in one place and observing people. They were all noisy, ugh. But there were so many pretty girls surrounding you, man. I was really jealous of that. I didn't really think about it. But why? You can find a girlfriend, man. Those girls I met, you know, they flirt and they go. I can never find true love at any party. Relax, man. Why so serious? Fine, whatever.
Yoga studio owner. Lately, I've been under stress.
How come?
I've been working overtime for a week. I feel like I can never finish all the tasks that my company gives to me. Plus, I think I have a backache.
Perhaps you might want to go to a yoga studio.
Yoga? I've never thought of it.
You can improve your health, both mentally and physically, by doing yoga. And, of course, it can help with back pain relief, too.
Sounds good. Do you know any yoga studios near here?
Yes, I have a friend of mine who is a yoga studio owner. I can give you her contact information.
Thank you so much. Good at networking.
Hey, look! Is that Sarah, the most popular girl in our school? Yes, that's her. And I think she's popular with everybody in this town.
Why do you say so?
Well, she's really good at networking. If you ask a random person on the street about Sarah, they will definitely know and can tell almost everything about her.
Wow, really?
Yes. She really knows how to make friends with everyone. A lot of people like her and will immediately give her a hand when she's in need. I'm an introvert who never knows how to start a conversation, and I think she's so cool.
You're right, man. I hope I can be good at communication like her. Hire a realtor.
I want to move in immediately.
Why? How's your current house?
Well, it's good, but the neighborhood has been in decline recently.
What's the matter?
Well, the crime rates keep increasing. There were 3 break-ins in my neighborhood in the last 2 weeks.
That's bad.
Yeah, and my home is a bit far from my company.
I think you can hire a realtor.
Do you know anyone that's trustworthy?
Unfortunately, no, but I know a really good website helping you to connect with real estate agents.
Sounds good. Please show me that. Cooking. I think I have to sign up for a cooking class.
Why? I think your cooking skill is perfect.
But I only know how to cook some basic dishes. I want to learn more new recipes to cook for you.
Thank you, honey. But if you don't have time, you can watch some cooking channels on TV and the internet. Then I can be the one who gives feedback for you.
That's a good idea. But whenever I want to try to make something new, you're all busy with your work.
I'm sorry about that, Bay. I cannot promise to spend more time with you because I'm leading a project. But I can make sure to try everything you cook for me.
All right. I forgive you because you're too sweet.
A new job.
I've heard you got a new job, Henry. Congratulations.
Thank you, Bob.
When did you start working?
Well, just a week ago.
How is your new company?
Everything looks good. I'm glad I got accepted into a dynamic working environment that everyone's excited to work every day. And I have a nice manager, too.
That's good for you. I hope that you can learn and grow with this job.
I'll try my best.
Ask for help.
I have no clue how to solve this equation. Do you know how to do it?
No idea. Guess we'll have to ask our teacher for help.
Or we can ask the smartest person in our class, Jason. Hey, Jason, what's the answer for question number 30?
Why do I have to tell you?
Oh, come on. I thought we were friends.
I'm sorry, but can you show us how to solve that question?
Let me see your notebook.
Here, I'm on this step, but... See, at least you should have asked politely like me.
Whatever.
Topic: Learn English with the Vlog Review. This is a series of videos to learn English through Vlog Review. And today, you're invited to join me to go to the grocery store and shop in English. Let's get started. Hello, everyone. My name is Sam from Samantha Shine. Have you ever gone to the grocery store? I bet you all have. But today, let's go to a grocery store in the U.S. I will take you around and pick up a couple of things. I will also explain along the way what they have in there. I hope you can learn something new and we will have a joyful ride today. Okay, let's go. We're going through the parking lot to get into the grocery store. Maybe you have heard the term supermarket, but it's called a grocery store in the U.S. We will get a cart. Or you can also say shopping cart. We will use it to collect the groceries that we want to buy. Now let's get inside and see what a grocery store in the U.S. is like. Last night I watched a video about a recipe with cooking instructions, so today I decided to cook it for dinner. I made a note of what to buy. I'm going to buy all these ingredients. And you have the task of guessing what I will cook. Our first stop is the produce section.
What can we find in the produce section? The produce section is the section we can find a lot of fruits and vegetables, such as oranges, bananas, apples, mangoes, and pineapples. I love apples. I eat an apple every morning. I will buy more apples. Let's see. We have single apples and bagged apples. I'll get the bag because I eat a lot of apples. And the bagged one is a better deal. Let's move on. We also have a lot of vegetables here. We have lettuce, tomatoes, cucumbers, carrots, broccoli, and those kinds of things. I'll buy carrots, broccoli, and red cabbage for dinner tonight. I also have to buy mushrooms. Here they are, dried shiitake mushrooms. And now I'm looking for garlic and ginger. I think they're near the herbs. Now we're at the deli section, where we can buy ready-to-eat items such as cold-cut meats, sliced cheeses, ham, bologna, sausage, and so much more. Do you often buy food in the deli section? I usually buy them and put them on sandwiches or sub sandwiches for breakfast. But today, I'll just buy sliced cheese from the deli section. So let's move on to the next thing. We're walking through the bakery. In the bakery section, we can get a wide selection of cakes, tarts, fresh bread, pies, donuts, cookies, and all other sweet-tasting offerings. And here is my favorite part, the birthday cake and cupcakes. I love the birthday cake so much. When I was a kid, I wished on my birthday that every month was my birthday, so that I could eat birthday cake all year round. But now I'm losing weight, so nope, not today. If you want to buy milk, we will move on to the dairy section. The dairy section has all things that would come from cow's milk, goat's milk, or sheep's milk. Here we can buy milk, butter, eggs, sour cream, ice cream, cream cheese, or yogurt. Do you see the words on sale? That means they can be bought for less than their normal price. It's a discount. Don't be confused with the term for sale. For sale means they are available for people to buy with no discount at all. I'll buy eggs for dinner and we'll go to the fish and meat section. Where did they hide the meat and seafood section? I think we should ask the staff for help. Excuse me, can you please tell me where I can find the meat and seafood section?
You go straight in this aisle, then turn right. Then you will see the fish and meat section.
Thank you. In this section, we can't get meat and fish by ourselves. We have to ask the staff to help again. I want to get a fresh cut of beef. Excuse me, I'd like 3 pounds of beef, please.
Sure, anything else?
No, that's all, thank you. Can you guess what I'm going to cook for dinner? If you haven't guessed yet, follow me to find the final ingredients. And this is the last ingredient that I need for today's dinner. Ramen noodles. Now, can you guess what I'm going to make for dinner? That's right. I will cook ramen noodle soup. I love spicy food, and I think that ramen noodle soup will hit the spot. Now it's time to check out and go home to prepare dinner. Near the checkout counter, you will find a lot of snacks and junk food here. My advice to you is to keep a cool head and ignore them. I know it's hard, but try your best. Let's take the final step at the grocery store.
Do you have a loyalty card?
No, I don't.
Did you bring your own bag?
Oh, I forgot.
Do you want paper or plastic?
Paper, please.
Would you like to pay by cash or credit card?
Can I pay with a debit card?
Sure.
Great, here it is.
Here's your receipt. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much for joining me today at the grocery store. That was a tour of the grocery store. I hope this video was helpful to you. Please comment where you want to go next time. Wherever you want to go, I will go with you. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!
Hello everyone, welcome to today's lesson. This video will include two parts. In part one, we will listen and learn vocabulary in different places with Wendy and Peter. In part two, there will be questions to test the vocabulary you learned before.
This video will help you learn and memorize vocabulary more easily. So, let's focus on watching and listening to improve your English. And see if you can answer the questions in the video correctly.
Hi everyone! Today I will pick up my friend, Peter from Australia. So now I'm at the airport waiting for him. In the meantime, let's learn some vocabulary at the airport together. First of all, this is a check-in counter. The check-in counter is a reserved area for passengers to check in. This is the process that passengers arriving at the airport must do. And when you complete the procedure, they give you a boarding pass. What is a boarding pass? The boarding pass is a special piece of paper that you must have to be allowed to get onto an airplane. So what is the difference between a flight ticket and a boarding pass? The difference is how you use them. You use a flight ticket or e-ticket to check in at the check-in counter and get your boarding pass. With the boarding pass, you get access to the security area in the airport and the airplane. Along with the boarding pass, we have the words boarding time. It means the time when the passengers can board the plane. Remember to never be late for boarding. Next, we have the words departure time. Departure time is the time when the plane leaves the gate of the airport. It's different from the boarding time. Do you see that girl? In her hand is a suitcase. You can also use the word baggage. That is a trolley or luggage cart. You use it to carry baggage. Next, we will learn about takeoff and landing. Can you guess what they mean? For the moment when an airplane leaves the ground and starts to fly, we use the word takeoff. And when the plane has arrived and comes down to the ground, we use the word landing.
Hi, Wendy.
Hi, Peter. Let me introduce you to everyone. This is my friend, Peter. He will go with us on the journey today.
Hello, everyone. I'm Peter. Nice to meet you.
Peter, today everyone will go with us and we will learn new English words together.
Sounds great.
Long time no see. How are you doing, Peter?
I'm doing great. How about you?
Never been better.
We haven't met for a long time.
That's right, since we graduated from high school.
Nice to see you today. I'm very excited to visit the famous places in your city.
Don't rush. I will be your tour guide today. Have you eaten anything?
You are right. I'm a bit hungry now. So, let's go eat first, and then we will go sightseeing.
Okay. Could I have a table for two, please?
Sure. Please, follow me.
The restaurant is also a very familiar topic. We've already learned it. Now let's review what words there are. Peter, do you want to show it to our new friends?
Of course. I will start first. At the restaurant, we have a menu.
If we have the menu, we can place our order. The person who takes orders and serves us food is called a waiter.
The one who cooks for us is a chef. This is a plate. This is a spoon and a fork.
Our menu today has soup as an appetizer. You can also call it a starter. Beef steak for the main course. The sweet dish is a dessert.
Great! Have you guys memorized the words?
Now Peter and I will enjoy our meal. See you guys later!
And don't forget to wish each other a delicious meal by saying, Bon Appetit!
How's the food, Peter?
Very delicious. I like it very much.
Really? This is my favorite restaurant.
Great. Ah, that's right, Wendy. After we finish eating, where do we go?
How about Disneyland? What do you think? There are so many things that we can enjoy.
Sounds interesting. All right, let's go there. We're here.
Then let's learn some vocabulary from Disneyland together.
Are you ready?
Let's go.
One of the features of Disney is the castle. And besides the castle, what else do we need to mention, Wendy?
It's definitely the princess and the prince.
Do you know all the princesses in Disney movies?
Of course I do. Disney movies are my childhood.
Oh, look at this. Groups of people dressed so colorful like movie characters and perform cheerful music. This is called a parade.
All right, let's move on.
Where do we go first, Wendy?
Do you want to go on a roller coaster? You can visit and see many places.
Of course. Today you are the tour guide. Wow. Look at it. They get me excited. So, our new word today is a roller coaster, right?
Yeah. A roller coaster is a ride that is like a small open train with tracks that are high off the ground and have sharp curves and steep hills. People will sit in small, fast, open cars to ride.
Let me explain some other new words I use here with you guys. We have railroad tracks. Let me see how to explain it.
You guys see over there are the railroad tracks. It is a pair of steel rails, a system of tracks that trains travel along.
Oh, I see. Let's go get the tickets.
Sure, I'm waiting here.
Wow, we played so many games today. I feel a bit tired and hungry.
Me too. Now let's go home. I will cook for you.
Oh, you can cook, Wendy?
Of course. I know how to cook a lot of dishes.
Wow, I'm looking forward to dinner tonight.
This is also the end of today's vocabulary lesson.
We hope that you have learned many useful vocabulary.
Don't forget to practice every day to improve your English.
Goodbye, and see you again.
Ah, today's video isn't over yet.
Let's go to the practice part together to review the vocabulary of today's lesson. In this part, we will practice the new words we have learned by answering multiple choice questions below. Let's get started.
Number 1. What is it? The answer is A, a roller coaster.
Number 2. What is his job? The correct one is B.
Number 3. Listen and choose the correct answer. Castle. Did you hear the answer? It's A, castle.
Number 4. What is it? The correct one is definitely C, baggage.
Number 5. What is Peter doing? The answer is A. Peter is ordering the food.
Number 6. Who is this? The princess. Did you get the correct answer? It's C, the princess.
Number 7. What is the plane doing? The correct one is definitely B, landing.
Number 8. Can you name all these dishes? Did you choose the right one? Yes, it's B.
Number 9. What is the name of this place? The answer is A, a check-in counter.
Number 10. Listen and choose the correct answer. Parade. The answer is C. I will catch up with you soon.
Hey, Jack. Thank you for hanging out with me today. I always travel to crowded places such as the beach or the amusement park. However, this is my first time visiting an art museum. I thought it was going to be boring, but it was actually relaxing.
I know, right?
Yeah, and you really did surprise me. I've never thought that you love aesthetic stuff.
Well, I must say that I have always been like this. I hope we can hang out at beautiful and quiet places like this again soon.
Yeah, it's a pity that I have to go home now.
Don't worry, I will catch up with you soon.
Yep, see ya.
One has to pass the time anyhow.
I'm so bored. I have to wait for my bicycle to be fixed. I cannot go anywhere now until the afternoon.
One has to pass the time anyhow.
If you said so, can you recommend some activities to pass the time?
Maybe you can learn a language.
Learning a language takes a lot of time. I can't spend a day mastering Japanese or Spanish or any other languages.
So, how about drawing and coloring with me?
You're so lame.
We just need to do it to pass the time, bro.
All right, let me do it with you. Don't move. Wait, Jenny, don't move.
What's going on? Why can't I move?
There's a snake right next to you. Don't make any sudden movements.
A snake? Are you serious?
Yes, I am. It's a venomous one. We need to be very careful.
What should we do then?
We need to slowly back away and get out of here. But we have to do it without disturbing the snake.
Okay, I'll try to move slowly. Do you know how to deal with snakes?
Yes, I do. I have some knowledge about them.
Just stay calm and don't panic. All right, let's start moving.
Okay, follow my lead. And remember, don't move too fast or make any sudden movement.
Got it. Thanks for warning me.
No problem. Let's get out of here safe.
Don't do that.
What are you doing, Bob?
I'm copying Henry's answers for the math homework.
Don't do that. What if your teacher finds out?
It's okay. I'm copying without her seeing. How would she know?
When the teacher checks your homework and Henry's homework, you will be in big trouble since you both have the same mistakes.
Oh gosh, you're right. But the homework was so difficult. I couldn't do it by myself.
It's okay to not understand something. You could ask your teacher for help later rather than copying, you know?
All right.
We do not travel first class.
Welcome home, David. How was your first flight?
It was tiring, but amazing. There's nothing to complain about the customer service.
Did you and your family sit in luxurious seats and enjoy top-notch food?
Oh, we do not travel first class.
Oh, so you just had economy class seats?
Yes, but we chose premium economy class seats.
I see. Did your mom choose those seats because she doesn't like sitting with a lot of people?
Yes, exactly. The premium economy class seats offer wider seats with fewer people.
That sounds nice. Did you experience any jet lag?
Not really, but my brother did. He felt exhausted and decided to sleep for a whole day after the flight.
Please be seated.
Thank you, Mrs. Brown. It's such an honor to be invited to your party.
Don't mention it. Now, dinner is ready. Please be seated, our lovely guests.
Excuse me, Mrs. Brown. May I ask what this dish is?
It's salmon and papillote, a French food.
It tastes so delicious.
Thank you. Our chefs worked really hard on that dish. Now it's time for dessert. We have creme brulee and palmier cookies. Which one do you prefer?
Well, I'd love to try the palmier cookies.
For me, I will go with creme brulee.
Let it be. Hey, Sherry, I need your help.
What's the matter?
I have an interview tomorrow and I am so worried.
What is the interview about? Is that a job interview?
No, it's just an interview to join the cooking club at our school.
Don't worry, just try your best.
Don't you think I should prepare and practice in advance?
Just let it be.
Let it be?
Yeah, it's just a club interview, so they won't ask serious questions. They just want to know whether you are interested in that club or not.
You're right. I feel much better.
Yep. You can prepare some questions if you want, but don't take it too seriously. Just relax and enjoy.
I agree. Allow me to introduce myself.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Jason. I am working as a marketing executive of LOYAL Company.
Nice to meet you, Jason. I'm Bob. I am also a marketing executive of a cosmetic company.
It's so special to meet someone working in the same field.
I agree. I hope that one day we will be able to work together.
Can I have your email, please?
Sure thing. It is.
He looks rather nervous.
Hello, Tom. Hi, Lucy. We have our math exam today, right?
Yeah, I am so nervous. I feel like I didn't study enough.
For me, I tried to review everything last night, so I believe I can do well on the exam.
Great to hear that.
Look at everyone else. I think they also prepared for the exams. We have Mason over there, and I think he's confident. He's always the top student in the math class.
Personally, he looks rather nervous.
Really?
Yeah, I feel like he's less confident than usual.
Never mind. Good luck to us.
Yep, best of luck.
Do you want to join me?
Hey, Linda. What are you gonna do on Halloween this year?
I plan to buy a ghost costume to scare everyone.
Wow, it's gonna be super fun. How about you?
I think I will decorate my house with some Halloween items.
Really? Your house will become super scary.
Yeah, do you want to join me?
Definitely, I will help you decorate the house.
First, we need to go shopping.
Have you decided what to buy?
Not yet. But I'm thinking about decorating outdoors with a tombstone.
Good idea. Anything else?
Maybe I need some creepy stickers for my front door.
Like spiderwebs?
That's a good one. I will write it down.
Oh, I'll never be able to understand fast speech. I feel helpless when listening to English. It's so fast that I can't get a word. I can't catch up.
Are these phrases and sentences familiar to you?
Have you ever said that before?
Well, I heard many people say things like that. If one of these ever crossed your mind, don't worry.
In this video, we'll help you sort this out.
And you'll know what to do when dealing with fast speech.
Part 1. Shadowing. In Part 1, you will listen to a sample of a short conversation. In this shadowing lesson, you will hear a story. Listen to the tone and the intonation in the voice. Try to imitate and copy the native English speaker.
Okay, let's give it a try.
I heard a bit of your talk about books. Are you still lost in the words of William Shakespeare? Have you found your hidden Romeo yet?
Lost for now. Mr. Romeo is hard to find, you know.
I wish there was a bit of sun to make the story less dark.
Metaphorically, I hope. This bookshop is not for sunbathing.
Ah, but you are, wouldn't you say? Your smile is like sunshine. It made me happy in the fiction section.
Well, although you're not my style, I must admit, you're quite smooth for a nerd.
About sunshine, I have the best present for you right here. Meet Midnight. He comes with a secret message. I got sunburned because of your smile.
This is adorable. The message is so playful, so you. I can't believe you even thought of me.
When I saw it, I knew it was for you.
Ben, you've made my day. This is the sweetest gesture. I'll cherish midnight forever.
Happy you like it. So, wanna go for coffee this weekend?
I have no plans, but now I want to. Coffee with you sounds nice.
Great. There's a small cafe nearby with seats outside. Good for sitting together.
Together, yes. Thanks for the fun and this lovely cat.
I'm happy, Lily. This is just the start of our book adventure, in sun or moon.
Can't wait. Who knew a bookshop visit could be so nice?
Life is full of surprises, like a book. Glad we're doing this together.
And about books, what do you like to read?
I like poems. I love how they sound and show pictures and words. And you?
I love old stories, but also mystery books. They are exciting.
Mystery and poems. A good mix. Maybe we talk about them over coffee?
Yes. I want to hear what you think about poems.
Happy to. Maybe you can show me a mystery book that is really good.
Deal. I'm excited for our coffee. It will be fun.
Me too. Can't wait for Saturday. See you then, Lily.
See you, Ben. Thanks again. Today was full of happy surprises.
Part 2. Vocabulary. Metaphorically. Explanation. Used to describe a situation where something is not literal but symbolic, indicating a comparison or representation. Example. When he said he was drowning in work, he meant it metaphorically, not that he was actually underwater. Cherish. Explanation. To cherish something means to hold it dear, to treat it with love and care, often because it holds personal or emotional significance. Example. She cherishes the necklace her grandmother gave her, wearing it on special occasions. Adorable. Explanation. Adorable is used to describe something or someone that is very charming, cute, or lovable, often evoking a warm, affectionate feeling. Example. The puppy's playful actions were so adorable that everyone wanted to cuddle it. Gesture. Explanation. A gesture is an action performed to convey a message, feeling, or intention, often carrying emotional or symbolic meaning. Example. Giving flowers as a gesture of apology, he hoped to mend their friendship. Sunburned. Explanation. Sunburned refers to the reddening, burning, or damage of the skin caused by prolonged exposure to the sun's ultraviolet rays. Example. After spending the day at the beach without sunscreen, she was sunburned and her skin felt sore. Part 3. Duet.
Lost for now. Mr. Romeo is hard to find, you know. Metaphorically, I hope. This bookshop is not for sunbathing. Well, although you're not my style, I must admit, you're quite smooth for a nerd.
This is adorable. The message is so playful. So you. I can't believe you even thought of me. Ben, you've made my day. This is the sweetest gesture. I'll cherish midnight forever. I have no plans, but now I want to. Coffee with you sounds nice. Together, yes. Thanks for the fun and this lovely cat. Can't wait. Who knew a bookshop visit could be so nice? And about books, what do you like to read? I love old stories, but also mystery books. They are exciting. Yes, I want to hear what you think about poems. Deal. I'm excited for our coffee. It will be fun. See you, Ben. Thanks again. Today was full of happy surprises.
A bad day at work. Honey, you won't believe the day I had at work.
Tell me all about it.
First, I had a meeting and completely forgot my notes.
Oh no, did you manage?
I had to wing it. Felt like a comedian on stage.
That must have been quite a show.
Then, I spilled coffee on my tie.
Your new one? Oh, dear.
Yep. Now it's a modern art piece.
You always find a way to make things positive.
I try. And guess what? I locked myself out of my office.
Again? Didn't that happen last month?
Yes, it's becoming a habit.
Well, at least your day can't get any worse.
Actually, it did. The boss caught me using my phone.
Not during the meeting.
Exactly during the meeting.
You're a disaster today.
But I'm still smiling.
That's why I love you. Ready for dinner?
Starving. What's for dinner?
Your favorite, spaghetti.
Perfect. Tomorrow will be a better day.
Yes, it will. And no coffee near your tie.
I'll drink it shirtless then.
Please don't. Let's keep the comedy off work.
Deal. Spaghetti, here I come.
Let's eat and forget about the bad day.
With you, every day is good.
Flattery will get you extra meatballs.
House renovating.
So we finally decided on painting the living room.
Yes, but choosing the color is another story.
I was thinking bright orange.
Bright orange? More like bright disaster.
Okay, maybe that's too bold. What about blue?
Blue might work, but not any blue, a calming blue.
Calming blue it is. Now, about the kitchen.
I want to change the tiles. They are so outdated.
Tiles are fine, but you remember last time, we couldn't cook for weeks.
This time will be different. We'll be more organized.
Organized chaos, you mean?
Let's not forget the bathroom. I want a new bathtub.
New bathtub? I hope it fits through the door this time.
We'll measure twice, order once.
And the garden? I was thinking of building a small deck.
A deck sounds lovely. But who will build it?
I thought I would give it a try.
Remember the bookshelf incident? Let's hire someone this time. Maybe someone who can measure properly.
Fair point, but I still want to help.
You can supervise with lemonade in hand.
Deal. And after all this, we deserve a vacation.
Absolutely. A vacation from our vacation home. What would you do 3 years from now?
Hey, what do you think you'll be doing 3 years from now?
Probably ruling the world.
Really? President Jamie, I like the sound of that.
Or maybe just trying to keep my plants alive.
From world leader to gardener, quite the change.
What about you, CEO of a tech giant?
Nah, I'll be happy if I can just fix my car by then.
Still struggling with that old thing?
It's a classic, thank you very much.
A classic that barely runs.
It has character, and it will be a luxury car in 3 years. If I can fix it.
Sure, and I'll be on the moon.
Planning a space trip?
Why not? Maybe I'll find your luxury car there too.
Very funny. We'll see who gets the last laugh in 3 years.
Deal. Let's meet here in 3 years. First one to the moon wins.
You're on. And if my car is not fixed, you can drive me in your spaceship.
It's a date. Now, let's go grab something to eat.
Only if you promise not to make fun of my classic anymore.
No promises, but I'll try.
That's all I ask. Lead the way, Moonwalker.
We'll get space-themed food.
As long as it's not moon-priced.
I'll see if I can get an astronaut discount.
Looking forward to it. Let's go.
To infinity and beyond.
The positive and negative effects of texting. What do you think of texting?
I think texting is great, but it has some downsides.
Really? I love texting. It's so convenient.
Yes, but sometimes it feels less personal.
Actually, I miss hearing people's voices sometimes.
Also, autocorrect can make texting hilarious or disastrous.
Oh, I know. Once it changed love to lava in a text to my mom.
Lava, that's too funny.
And don't forget about texting thumb. It's real.
Texting thumb? Never heard of it.
It's when your thumbs hurt from too much texting.
That sounds painful. But texting keeps us connected more easily.
Yes, especially when we are far apart.
But it also means we're always available, no privacy.
True. Sometimes I just want to throw my phone away.
Don't do that. What about all of our funny texts?
I guess I'll keep it for the texts and emojis.
Emojis are the best. They add fun to any text.
But they can be misunderstood too.
True. Once I sent a thumbs up emoji and my friend thought I was mad.
Mad? How?
He thought it was sarcastic. Context is everything.
Texting is a whole new language.
Absolutely. It's funny how we adapt to it.
True,
but nothing beats a good old phone call.
I agree. Maybe we should call more often?
Let's do that. But I still love texting you funny GIFs.
And I love receiving them. Keeps the day bright.
So texting is good, but in moderation, right?
Exactly. Balance is key.
Let's text less and talk more.
Deal. Starting with a call tonight?
What is your busiest day of the week?
What's your busiest day of the week?
Definitely Monday. It's like a tornado at work.
A tornado? That sounds intense.
Oh, it is. Emails, meetings, and coffee spills.
Coffee spills?
Every Monday, like clockwork, I'm a spill magnet.
Maybe you need a sippy cup.
Very funny. What about you?
Thursday. It's my everything happens day.
Everything happens?
Yep. Last Thursday, I lost my keys, missed lunch, and locked myself out.
That's a disaster.
And I had to climb in my house through a window.
Please tell me someone saw that.
My neighbor. She couldn't stop laughing.
I would pay to see that.
Thanks for the support.
Anytime. So how do you survive Thursdays?
I just keep reminding myself tomorrow is Friday.
Smart move.
And not to spill coffee. Learn from the best.
Hey, I might start a trend.
The Monday Spill Club?
Exactly. Members get free sippy cups.
Sign me up.
You'll be our first member.
I'm honored. The perks of being clumsy.
Do you make a schedule for every day?
Do you make a schedule for every day?
Me? Schedule? That's a good joke.
So you just wing it every day?
Basically, yes. It's more exciting.
But how do you get things done?
I'm like a ninja. I strike when the time is right.
A ninja with a to-do list?
More like a ninja with a forget-to-do list.
That sounds chaotic.
Life is an adventure, Alice.
And your adventure never includes planning?
Only if the adventure is grocery shopping.
I can't even imagine your grocery trips.
Let's just say, I never leave with what I planned.
You're impossible. How do you manage work?
Work is different. I have sticky notes, lots of them.
Ah, the ninja's secret weapon,
sticky notes. Exactly. They're all over my computer.
Your computer looks like a colorful mess.
It's a masterpiece of organized chaos.
Well, my life is a bit more structured.
Do you plan every minute?
Not every minute, but I like knowing what's next.
Sounds less ninja, more robot to me.
A robot that gets things done?
True. Maybe I should try your way.
A schedule? You? I'll believe it when I see it.
Challenge accepted. Tomorrow, I'll be Mr. Organized.
I'll prepare to be amazed or amused.
You just wait. The new Bob is coming.
When was your first trip abroad?
Mia, when was your first trip abroad?
Oh, it was a disaster. I went to Italy when I was 18.
Italy? Sounds amazing. What happened?
I lost my passport on the first day.
No way. What did you do?
I panicked. Luckily, I found it in my other bag.
That's a relief. Anything else funny happen?
I tried ordering pasta and accidentally asked for a kiss instead.
That must have been awkward.
The waiter just laughed at me and said, I can speak English. I was so embarrassed.
He's a funny guy.
How about you? Any fun on your first trip?
My first trip was to Mexico. Also funny.
Really? Tell me about it.
I thought I could handle spicy food. I was wrong.
Oh no, what happened?
I ate a whole chili pepper. My face turned red.
I can imagine. Did you drink a lot of water?
Tons. And I learned a valuable lesson.
Which is?
Always ask how spicy it is first.
Good advice. Traveling is always an adventure.
Yeah, and it teaches us so much. Where to next?
I'm thinking Japan. I love sushi.
Japan sounds great. Just watch out for wasabi.
Oh, I will. I don't want a repeat of your chili incident.
Let's plan our next trip.
That would be fun. A travel buddy to share adventures with.
Exactly. We'll make unforgettable memories.
Can't wait. It'll be a blast.
When was the last time you danced?
When was the last time you danced?
Danced? Oh, you'll laugh. It was at a cousin's wedding.
I promise I won't laugh. Tell me more.
I tried to do the salsa. It was a disaster.
Salsa? That's brave. What happened?
I stepped on so many toes, even my own.
Oh no, that sounds painful.
It was, but everyone was laughing, so it was fun too. Your turn. When did you last dance?
At a friend's party. Tried to break dance.
Break dance? That's intense. How did it go?
Let's just say I broke more than just the dance.
Oh no. Were you okay?
Yeah, just my pride was hurt.
We should go dancing together sometime.
That sounds like a fun disaster waiting to happen.
We can step on toes together.
Can't wait to see how that turns out.
We'll be the stars of the dance floor.
Or the clowns.
Either way, it'll be memorable.
Hey, how about we try it right now?
Now? Are you sure?
Yeah, we're at a party, Lisa. This is our chance to shine.
Well, okay. Let's warn everyone about their toes first.
Haha, guess they won't mind.
Let's dance.
Have you ever tried to lose weight?
I've been thinking about losing weight. Have you ever tried?
Oh, many times. It's always an adventure.
What kind of adventure?
Last time, I tried a diet. Only green foods for a week.
Green foods? Like vegetables?
Yes, but I added green ice cream, too.
That's not how it works.
I figured that out quickly.
Any other attempts?
I joined a gym. Went once. Lost my gym card.
That was quick.
Then, I tried jogging every morning.
How did that go?
I overslept every morning.
Sounds like you've had some challenges.
Definitely, but I haven't given up yet.
That's the spirit. Any plans now?
Thinking of trying yoga next.
Yoga sounds like a good idea.
Yeah, unless I fall asleep during meditation.
I can totally see that happening.
Want to join me for yoga?
Sure, why not? It might be fun.
Let's see who falls asleep first.
You're on, but let's try to actually do some yoga.
Deal. I'll set multiple alarms.
I'll bring some green smoothies.
Green smoothies. Now you're talking.
See you at yoga class, Bob. No green ice cream.
Got it. Just the healthy stuff.
When did you first drive a car? Guess what I found? My old driving test photo.
Oh, wow. Let's see. When did you first drive a car?
I was 16. It was my dad's old truck, a real monster.
I bet that was a challenge.
Absolutely. I couldn't even see over the dashboard.
So, what happened?
First time I tried to park, I hit a mailbox.
No way! What did your dad say?
He wasn't happy. That's a mailbox, not a Target.
That's hilarious. Did you ever get better at driving it?
Eventually, yes, but we had to fix more mailboxes first.
How about your first time driving, Jamie?
Oh, mine was a tiny car,
but I was so nervous. Did anything happen?
I drove so slowly, a bicycle passed me.
You're kidding. That must have been embarrassing.
It was. My brother still teases me about it.
I guess we all have our funny driving stories.
True, but now I love driving.
Same here, though I stay away from mailboxes.
And I'm faster than bicycles now.
We've come a long way since then.
Boredom.
Do you ever get bored, Tom?
Bored. I invented boredom.
Really? How so?
I once watched paint dry for fun.
No way. That's too much.
Yes way. And I counted grass once.
Tom, you need a hobby.
Counting grass can be a hobby.
Okay, but what about something more exciting?
Like what? Extreme ironing?
Is that even a thing?
I wish. I usually just read or watch TV.
What do you read?
Dictionaries. I like new words.
That's unique.
I know, right?
I'm impressed and a bit worried.
Don't be. I also talk to my plants.
Do they talk back?
Well, no, but they're great listeners.
I would be really worried if you said yes.
Then maybe I can make a plant English dictionary.
Tom, you're one of a kind.
Thank you. I take pride in my boredom.
Ever think about trying something new?
Like skydiving with a dictionary?
Maybe start with something less extreme.
Fine. How about a cooking class?
That's a great idea. I'll join you.
Cooking with Alice. This could be fun.
See, you're already less bored.
Thanks to you. Let's find a class.
What takes up most of your time?
What takes up most of your time these days?
Oh, my phone, definitely. I'm always on it.
Oh.
Social media, games, news, it never ends.
I get that. I spend hours just scrolling.
It's a black hole of time.
But you know, work takes up most of my time.
Right. Meetings, emails, more meetings.
And don't forget the urgent tasks.
Oh, the urgent ones that aren't really urgent?
Exactly. Every day is a new task.
Don't you wish there were more hours in a day?
All the time. I'd probably still waste them.
True. We should find something else to fill them with.
How about sleep? That's a good time spender.
Sleep. My long-lost friend.
Remember naps? Those were the days.
Naps are a luxury now, like rare diamonds.
We should start a nap club.
Best idea ever. Sign me up.
Do you ever feel like we're just busy being busy?
All the time. It's the modern curse.
Well, at least we're in it together.
That's the silver lining.
Now, let's go find some time to waste.
As long as it's fun, I'm in.
Have you ever done any volunteer work?
Jamie, have you ever done any volunteer work?
Yeah, I volunteered at an animal shelter once.
Really? How was that?
It was interesting. I got chased by a goose.
A goose? That's hilarious.
Not all the time. I was terrified.
Did you manage to escape?
Yeah, I jumped over a fence. Felt like an action hero.
That's one way to make volunteering exciting.
How about you? Any volunteering stories?
I helped at a senior center once.
Sounds nice. What did you do?
I was supposed to help with a dance class.
Supposed to?
Well, I accidentally played hip-hop music.
At a senior dance class?
Yep, you should have seen their faces.
I can only imagine. Did they like it?
Surprisingly, yes. We had a hip-hop dance party.
That's awesome. Volunteering can be full of surprises.
Absolutely. It's rewarding in unexpected ways.
Would you do it again?
Definitely. But next time, I'll check the music playlist first.
And I'll stay away from geese.
Sounds like a plan. Volunteering, but safely.
Let's find a new place to volunteer together. Have you ever dialed the wrong number?
Have I ever told you about the time I dialed the wrong number?
No. What happened?
I was trying to call a pizza place.
And?
I ended up calling a karate school instead.
Karate school? How did that happen?
I mixed up the last two digits.
So what did you say?
I asked if I could order a large pepperoni pizza.
I can't believe it. What did they say?
They said, "Do you want to kick or punch with that?"
That's hilarious. Did you realize then?
Not immediately. I thought it was a new promotion.
You thought a karate school was selling pizza?
Yeah. I even asked about toppings.
What did they say then?
They told me to come over and pick them up myself.
And did you go?
Of course not. I finally realized my mistake.
That's too funny. Did you ever get your pizza?
Yes, but from the right place this time.
I bet you double-checked the number.
Definitely. No more karate pizza for me.
Next time, let me order the pizza.
Good idea. You're the pizza expert.
And no karate.
Promise. Just pizza and chill.
That's more like it. Pizza night, here we come.
With the correct number this time.
Absolutely. Let's go.
If you had one wish, what would you wish for?
If you had one wish, what would you wish for?
That's tough. Maybe $1 million?
Just $1 million? Think bigger.
Okay, $1 billion then.
Now we're talking. I'd wish for unlimited pizza.
Pizza? Really? Not world peace or something?
I love pizza. What can I say?
$1 billion can buy a lot of pizza, you know.
True, but I like my wish. Simple and delicious.
What if the pizza makes you fat?
I'd wish for super fast metabolism too.
Smart, but I'd still stick with $1 billion.
What would you do with all that money?
Travel the world, buy a house, and a yacht.
A yacht? That's fancy.
Why not? Go big or go home.
I'll come for the yacht parties, okay?
Only if you bring the pizza.
Deal. It's a pizza yacht party then.
Now I really want that $1 billion.
And I really want that pizza.
Maybe we should just buy a lottery ticket.
With our luck, we'd win just enough for pizza.
As long as it's good pizza, I'm in.
Don't forget to practice your English every day to improve your English level. Watch the video for 1 week. Try to think and speak in English every time. Listen and repeat the lesson out loud to improve your listening and speaking skills fast. Thanks for watching. Please give us a like, share, and comment. Click here for more useful videos.